under this beautiful weather, the game between the Rio Salt Lake and the San Jose Earthquakes is about to begin. This is the reaction of the coach and the players of the San Jose Earthquakes.
I thought they defended great, actually, with eight men. Very difficult for them. What I will say is difficult to play against that, though, when there's eight guys behind the ball around the box. You know, you've got to get some clear-cut chances. It might have been a bit more open if they had, obviously, full strength. But who knows how it would have went. What I do know is our team played really well tonight, and we deserve to win the game. Two headers. I think service was coming in all night. That, you know, we put on Alan and Lenny to kind of shake it up a little bit with their power in the box. And I think, you know, Wando gets his goal and Simon comes in late with a great finish too. So, you know, I got to hold my, or say that the team was just, the guys were great. They were patient. We didn't get panicked. Even in the last few minutes of the game, you know, we hadn't scored yet. I felt it was just a very mature performance by us.
One more question, sir. How do you feel having a ball possession? How was that an advantage to your game plan?
Well, it's pretty, I shouldn't say it's easy, but it's a little easier when they got eight men, even with nine men, you know. Sorry, nine men. We had 10 men. So, you know, for me, it was always, we had to move the ball sharply. We had to make sure that we could spread the play. And I thought we did that well. You know, we didn't quite get the finishes up until we did score, but I thought we created some great chances to score, and it was just nice to see that one go in from Simon.
What was the difference last year, a man up, you guys didn't score?
Well, I think quality on the field, you know, I think that, and belief. I think that, you know, I don't tend to waver much on, you know, getting too high and too low, but I think the team has talent. I think that they have good belief, and I said all along that the team spirit in the dressing room right now, this whole season, as soon as the new guys come in, and even the fellas that we've kept have great attitudes, and they want to do well, and they really want to win. And I think that they proved that tonight.
Kick stand, like on the play of the right flank from Baca, and then when you go on Garza, how they...
Great. I mean, Sam Garza is a good player. You know, he hasn't really had a chance to play yet. I thought he was good. You know, he had a couple of good plays. I mean, Rafa's playing great. I thought Tresor Moreno coming in for his first game start, second start, I think it was great, played well. I mean, I can't really pick out anybody who played poorly, to be honest. You know, Icapara is playing with a little bit of a hamstring. He was a warrior tonight, stayed in there, but Jason was good, John Bush was clean. So a lot of good performances from our guys.
So top of the league now, Frank, and the Quakes have earned it. So what are the challenges ahead?
Well, obviously keeping a good run going that we have. You know what, I feel that the team, we had a lot of changes to the lineup tonight, but it didn't stutter. I thought that we come out of the gate, and we talked about it all week, about, you know, it's a chop opportunity for some guys that have not played too much this year. But, and I said to him, it's not your second rate, you've not had a chance to play, you know, and the team's done well, and it's flowed, and we've got results, so you don't really tend to change that. But, you know, and I think I stated it right at the start, is at some point you will get a chance to play, for sure. you know, each individual player will get a chance, whether it's 5 minutes, 10 minutes, or 50, you know, 30 games, you'll be on there. So make sure you're ready. And I thought the guys that come into the side tonight were fantastic. Yeah, Curry's a good player. I mean, you know, let's take nothing away from him. He scored 6 goals last year for us. He scored tonight. I think he's been dangerous in a lot of games he's played in for us this year. And he's invaluable in his versatility. You know, we put him at defensive midfield or sitting midfielder when they lost the second player. You know, and Sam was playing great too. And, you know, we just think Curry on the field gives us a chance of scoring. But Sam's obviously a good possession player. But we felt we needed to keep Curry on the pitch just for shots and different things like that. So he's versatile, goes up front, he goes in midfield, you know, and I think he really earns his spot. Well, I don't really, you know, I don't put a lot into it, to be honest. It's you know, it's obviously, you know, they get counted up and it ends up 100 wins, but, you know, I just want to do well for this club and you know, hopefully I can get a few more and we can make the playoffs and everyone will be happy that's involved in the club, but, you know, from the front office that worked very hard to make our stadium full, and they did a fantastic job again. To the players, to the staff that I have. I got a great coaching staff here that really helped me out with everything that I do as an individual, and so it's not just, you know, it's not just me at all. I never want that to be said. I want to make sure that I've been helped along the way with great players, good players, I should say, great players, great staff, great support.
Giving out a lot of cards today, did it affect your reasoning of putting Lindhardt in, who has been collecting a lot of yellow cards, knowing that this ref has been handing out a ton of cards?
Yeah, no. Put Lenny in was to change the game. Not worrying about the yellow cards for him. I don't even know what he got his yellow card for, to be honest. But you know, he seems to attract attention because of the way he plays. But he plays aggressively and usually pretty fair. So, you know, I'm not sure what it was. Here's it, yeah, it must be. Well, just get, you know, once they went down, two men down, it was just to get that goal. And I think that we struggled for a little bit with it, but I thought we created some great chances. It was just nice to get that goal right at the end and obviously win the game.
Who played the best game?
All my players play well. You're welcome.
Aquí todo esto es para el show internacional. Y aquí estamos más con el juego de los Earthquakes. Aquí está Moreno. Cuéntame un poquito cuál fue tu expectativa de juego de hoy.
Bueno, la expectativa era hacer un partido interesante donde San José pudiera jugar bien, pudiera ganar y seguir demostrando que partido tras partido vamos hacia un objetivo que es hacer una temporada muy, pero muy buena.
Muchísimas gracias. Y bueno, ¿y cuáles son tus expectativas para los juegos que vienen?
Las expectativas siempre son jugar. Ya tuve la oportunidad hoy. Espero aprovechar cada partido que tenga y seguir teniendo la posibilidad y la confianza del entrenador.
Muchísimas gracias. Bueno, aquí seguimos más con el show internacional Wire TV de Los Ángeles, California. Gracias.
Yeah, definitely. You know, to be honest, I think that they are obviously one of the best teams in the league. You know, they've won a championship the past couple of years, and you know, I think it helped us being two men up to beat them. But to be honest, even when it was even for the first 30 minutes, I thought that we had a little bit more of the play, a little bit more possession, and a couple of the better chances. But you know, they're a very good team, and it was just, you know, anytime you come away with 3 points against them, you just got to take it however you can.